Okay, this is AC.
And this is Rob.
We're playing Streets of Rage on the Sega Mega Drive, nay Genesis.
Andrew, are your streets raging?
My streets are fully raging. And this is 16-bit Seizure. We're just listening to the title sequence at the moment, watching it.
Better get the rich backstory of this game.
Yeah, I wasn't motivated to play this until I heard the backstory. Alright, I think we'll, normal?
Yeah, let's do normal.
Do normal, attack, yeah. Jump, and special attack?
I think that's, yeah.
That's probably the best one, because I kept pressing A when it was...
Yeah, I think keeping a special attack on C is a good idea. Choice. Alright, well, do you have a bit of a brosif party?
Bro? Can you go bro?
Yeah, let's do it.
Go for bro.
Okay, so I'm Axel.
I'm Axel.
You're Axel?
I don't know.
Who's Axel? Which one?
We don't
Axel?
Even know which port the controller's in. Alright, no, I'm...
Okay, I'm this guy with the jeans. Sweet tight jeans.
Sweet tight jeans. It was the 80s. Or possibly early 90s. I think it might be early 90s.
So in this game, the police decide to take the fight to the streets. Instead of sitting in their offices, just you know, letting crime occur. We're out here doing the hard work. Punching thugs in the face.
So these guys are police officers, right? I mean...
Yeah, I think so. I don't think they're vigilant. I think the idea is that...
They're like 21 Jump Street or something. Or
yeah, that's right.
Except older, which doesn't make sense, I suppose.
Yeah, there's some. I don't know what it is about the tight jeans and the singlet tops that don't say police to me, but... I would ask these guys to show me their badge, that's what I'm saying.
I don't know, their jeans are so tight and they're wearing tank tops. I'm not sure where they'd be keeping their badges.
That's right.
If they pull one out, I'd be very suspicious.
Badge just slotted in there between the man boobs.
Okay, there's one of those things that if you walk up to the other person, you can kind of do a double move team. You can hurt each other. But, yeah. So, yep, like that. Now you press attack. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So
okay.
We can totally double team it up.
Oh, God, sorry.
Van Damme style. Van Damme and what was that other guy's name? Rodney? Romney? I don't know.
Van Damme and... I don't know.
That basketball player. We're Australian folks, if you couldn't tell from the accent. So basketball is now forte. We could totally make a Melman image
of
that.
You mean like the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar or something?
I don't think that's it.
Oh, a bottle. This is something Australians know all about. Hitting people with beer bottles.
Usually they're broken. Our bottles are in fact manufactured to break on the edge of bar tables.
Oh. Oh. Whoops. Sorry, buddy. Another man in his beard. Got Rach's shop.
Haven't we already passed that?
There's
another one.
It's a big shop.
It's a very big shop. They're taking over this town. They're the real criminals here.
Yeah, it's because the rent on that place is so high that they have to turn to crime to pay for it.
I suppose these days it'd be Starbucks. I can't use the bottle for some reason. It just keeps getting knocked out of my hand. This guy just prefers to use his fists naturally. He likes fisting.
Don't we all? Ladies. Am I right?
Yes. I'm sure we're going to get a big female audience.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, with great A material like this, I just picked an apple up off the street.
My wife is actually sitting in the background, not talking. And if I say something really bad, I'm assuming she's going to come over and hit me. So, as much as she loathes being on tape.
Got the sweet station wagon.
Looks like a Mitsubishi.
You know, when I was a kid, I used to play this game, and it always struck me as a 10-year-old playing this game that, in what world is it okay for policemen to pick up lead pipes and just hit people? Like, and these guys haven't even done anything wrong. They're just walking at us with.
They're obviously in a gang. They've got purple hair. Imagine if that was the case these days. You'd go to a cosplay convention and just kill everyone.
You'd just start hitting everyone with a big metal pipe.
You're in a gang! Oh no, you're in a gang!
I'm just cosplaying as Naruto. Just hitting with a massive.
If you're cosplaying as Naruto, you better know the fucking moves as well.
Yeah. Can we get that pipe seeing that I've got this knife?
You can always go with that pipe.
Just threw my knife at that lady.
Oh. See, this guy's really useless at using weapons.
Different animations or something. Back at the old pine pot. We've basically done a circle of the block. We're back where we started.
That's probably it. We're just walking around the block, beating up as many people as we can.
It's a good way to spend the weekend. So I've got... I've got this superhero. I can't remember what this guy's super does.
Well, I think he calls for backup, basically, and a police car comes along and fires a bazooka or missile launcher or something like that.
Right.
Or okay. Fires a minigun into the air and all the bullets. Just kind of... Right. Hang on, that looks really sus. Yeah, baby. Because you do kind of look like Patrick Swayze. Right, I'm going to use my special as a demonstration here.
These French guys are attacking us with boomerangs.
French guys? What?
I assume they're French. They've got red stripy shirts. And... They look French. Racially profiling these guys. Alright. Yeah,
That's a pretty sweet police car.
Looks like the Gadget... Do you think it looks a bit like the Gadget Mobile?
Go, go, Gadget Mobile!
I think Inspector Gadget is helping us.
He's finally got an arsenal.
Yeah, they gave him a minigun.
Yeah, if you run out of supers and you use it, he's just his umbrella just comes out. Yeah, we got these guys. It's almost too easy.
Hey, that literally was too easy. Next! Alright.
Maybe we should be playing this on difficult.
Do we get our health back at the end of each round?
I think so. But we haven't lost any lives yet, so...
Hopefully we can just keep going this way. Alright, onwards, round two. That took a couple of minutes, so... We should be good. Alright, more streets full of rage that they're cleaning up. He's wearing knee pads. You know, the 80s were a weird time.
I'm pretty sure this was probably made in the 80s, but it was definitely released in the early 90s.
Yeah, I think.
I think.
It's definitely got the aesthetic of the 80s, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Hadn't quite figured out where the 90s were going yet, and it turns out that it was going in a fluoro direction.
Yeah, that's right. No one could have predicted that at the time, but... What is that guy even wearing? Like, these guys, like, you know, like, he's wearing, like... Denim.
You know who this guy looks like? He looks like the guy from that Capcom game, Trojan.
Yeah.
So generic, red-haired, blue-body kind of guy.
Saying that this is the world. This is what the world was like before the apocalypse that occurs that causes Trojan.
Trojan is an NES game based off an arcade in about 1986, and it's a very early kind of one-dimensional fighter, and I mean one-dimensional in the fact that you can only really move side to side, yet it kind of plays like a beat-em-up, except you can't really dodge anything much.
Yeah, there's no plane, there's no, like, vertical plane.
Yeah, it's only horizontal.
Movement. Yeah, so you...
And it must have been a fun game at the time, but it's actually pretty terrible now. And incredibly generic.
I'm just gonna stab these redheads. Die, Ranga, die! Wait, is that... Is that discriminatory?
We're going to insult everyone by the end of this.
Get you good. Come here, Gillard.
Right. Gillard. See, the problem is, when you're fighting an enemy, and I got the knife, I don't think the knife is going to sail soundlessly through you and kill our enemy.
No. Ooh, what the hell was that? Are that lives? Is that extra lives?
I think so, yeah. If there's another one in there... Oh yeah, that's a totes. I'm not usually the kind of guy that says totes, by the way. I'm just trying to be cool.
Very hip. Very happy. Man, that lady did not like being stabbed with a broken glass bottle. Surprisingly enough.
Oh!
This is something, doesn't it? I don't really think it's something, don't you, buddy? Is that sex? Does someone write sex on the wall there? Is that what it says?
It like, does right? look like sex. I'm going to say it's right sex. There.
God. It looks like a six-year-old with a crayon.
Because that's what we were all thinking about when we were six.
Pretty much what I was thinking about. What about you?
Pretty sure I was thinking about Inspector Gadget at the time.
So was I. Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
That penny. Ooh. That brain.
Whoa. That brain.
You know, there are many kinds of love. These guys are just waiting for me. They're just
it's lining up for you.
Literally, it's lining up.
So I think you've mastered the lead pipe. You gotta, like, it kind of takes a little while to swing.
Yeah,
so you gotta wait till they're almost upon you, but not quite on top of you.
Yeah, there's a bit of a delay from when you hit it to when it actually, like...
Probably on purpose, too. This is of course, the answer to Double Dragon and all those other kind of fighters.
Yeah, I think this was a response to the arcade success of Final Fight. And they made a Final Fight-ish game. You know, the similarities between this and Final Fight are so great that it's hard not to think that there's some influence there, even if it was just an inspiration or... something like that. I think this is the game stands on its merits, and I don't think you can just say, oh, this is just a rip-off of Final Fight or something like that, or like a console version of Final Fight. Sega trying to steal the thunder.
It is a good game, and it's really playable.
Yeah.
And of course it's something we remember from our childhoods.
And I think unlike Final Fight, like, there is... Obviously you can play Final Fight on the SNES, if you so desire. But this game, because it's designed as a console game from the start, I think it plays better as a console game. It's more fun. The difficulty curve is a little less punishing, so you don't feel like you're failing the game like you do when you play Final Fight all the time.
Remember when the first time I finished Final Fight, it took us about 4 hours and we had unlimited lives.
Yeah.
And it still took us that long. I think I was on the Amiga or something.
Yeah, we definitely. Sweet time with
whoops.
You did that?
I accidentally did that, yes. My thumbs are big and the controller is somewhat small.
Go catch a bazooka!
He's just ending going, oh fuck.
I like how he freaks out. That is pretty great. What does it say here?
Something Street?
Something Street? Man.
Sex Street?
Yeah, Sex Street.
Of course, I used my special ability just before.
Oh. The boss, of course, yeah. It's all good, old Robbie's.
So that's
here.
The other one, the minigun?
So he fires it upwards and the bullets kind of like curve down and...
It's very accurate firing, and they never hit us once.
Oh gosh. It seems like the police are more of a menace than the criminals in this game.
Oh.
It's the third-rate Freddy Krueger's. All you can hear right now is just me tapping the button furiously.
As much as I'm sure you're all enjoying our witty commentary,
sometimes
because we're men, we can only do one thing at a time.
That's right. Sometimes you just gotta stab a giant freak with a knife.
that's like the motto under our coat of arms in Australia. Sometimes you just gotta stab the freak with the knife.
Hmm.
Alright, come back for part two.
Yeah, see you soon.